Good morning everyone. I am Veerana, lecturer in computer engineering. Today I am going to talk about the topic deadlock. This concept is from operating system. Deadlock, it is situationally occurred in operating system. Situationally means when the two processes are waiting for each other, then the both the processes are in wait state. This wait state is called deadlock. Generally, the deadlock situation occur in multitasking and client and server environment. Here, multitasking means ability to execute more than one process at a time. This is multitasking. For example, in the real world, when we give request to the printer, then immediately we give one more request to the printer, the second request will wait state until the first process may be completed. Here the printer is the resource. This is deadlock situation. For occurring deadlock situation, there are four conditions are there. First one, mutual exclusion, and second one, hold and wait, third one, no preemption, and the final one, circular wait. Going to first one, mutual exclusion. Here, no resources can be shared by more than one process at a time. If it will, it is in deadlock situation. And the second one, hold and wait. There must exist a process that is holding at least one resource and waiting to acquire additional resources that are held by other processes. This is hold and wait. And third one, no preemption. Resources cannot be preempted. Here, resources cannot be preempted means once a process can hold a resource that cannot be taken over by other process. And the final one, circular wait. Here, each process are in wait state because to obtain the resource that are held by the process. And for handling the deadlock situation, we have two steps. We have four procedures. First one, deadlock preemption, and second one, deadlock avoidance, third one, deadlock detection, and fourth one, deadlock recovery. Going to first one, deadlock preemption. Here, prevents deadlock to stop request. And the second one, deadlock avoidance. Here when the process can hold the resource, the remaining request can be avoided. And the third one, deadlock detection. Here, deadlock detection may allow, but it can detect it. And the final one, deadlock recovery. Here, after detecting the deadlock, it can recover by using some algorithms. Thank you. Thank you for listening my class.